I'm Florencia Orosz Hunziker, and I'm an assistant professor at the University of Colorado Boulder. I wouldn't say so. I like math, and I had no difficulty working on my math problems in school, but I wasn't particularly drawn to it or remarkably good at it. I don't think I knew I wanted to become a mathematician until I was an advanced undergrad trying to get a math degree. The reason I say this, so I'm from Argentina, and higher education is completely free. So I started a math degree just because it was something I wanted to try and see if I liked. I felt like I didn't know a lot of mathematics. I wanted to get some math training. I thought it would be good to develop the patience required to study such interesting abstract ideas. And once I started taking many, many, many classes, I got very, very interested in algebras and the algebras in particular. And then I learned from professors that one could do research for a living. And it was probably in my fourth year as an undergrad. We have 5 years as part of our degree in Argentina. My fourth year and my fifth year in which I decided I wanted to be a mathematician. I work in algebra and in particular in representation theory. And maybe before I tell you what structure I study, I would like to show you this square, and I want you to think of its symmetry. So this would be a symmetry of the square, and this would be a different one. You can maybe reflect across this line or across this diagonal. And if you think of all the actions you could apply to this square without changing its shape, those form a group. And more generally, the symmetries of more complicated systems give us different algebraic structures. I study vertex algebras, which are the rigorous algebraic structure that arises if you study the symmetries of a conformal field theory, which is an important theory in physics that relates to string theory and other concepts. I think there have been several. In particular, during my PhD, I had a really, really hard time processing such huge differences between my new program in the United States when compared to my previous experience in Argentina. Even though, of course, in Argentina, there was sexism in mathematical spaces, I had never felt so isolated and so underestimated before as I did when I started my PhD and throughout my PhD in general. So some parts of my identity made people assume in general negative things about me, even before I opened my mouth. And having the language to name this, having the resources to understand this, and thinking of ways to reject these ideas or to not let them discouraged me from participating in mathematical spaces took a really long time and a lot of collective effort. I will say that without a community of friends and colleagues who are generous, supportive, and generous with their time in discussing these issues, and also a community of colleagues that I don't know very well because, you know, we're not personal friends, but these are people who are publishing blogs or organizing video interviews from marginalized mathematicians and, you know, people who are constantly working to kind of put this phenomena into words, have been extremely helpful to me. So having, learning to find the words and learning to organize with others to try to think of ways in which we can change many of this hostile environments that people find in mathematical spaces was really important to me. When I was a grad student and I was feeling really isolated and quite discouraged for many years, we were able to organize with a group of postdocs and grad students, Intersections, which was an association for women and gender minorities at Yale. And We organized a few seminar talks and we had a few social events. And I think in an environment in which I actually felt quite isolated and powerless, being able, despite that huge powerlessness that I felt, being able to speak up, if only a little, and organize with others in some way that contributed, I think, to opening up conversations and generating space for people to come tell me about some experiences they had and why they thought they weren't helpful or constructive, or undergrads that could come and talk to me about things we should change to make our program more inclusive and more supportive of women and gender minorities. I think that's one of my proudest accomplishments, even though I think, the change we brought in immediately was not huge. For me personally, that was a huge moment because it was a moment in which I learned that if I, put aside maybe the fear or the isolation and started talking and started organizing with others, many, many, many people could find a place to kind of talk, share, grow, and brainstorm ways to deal maybe with situations of harassment or situations of bullying or situations of, other unwelcoming attitudes. Maybe in the same note, I was able to organize a directed reading program in which we focused on learning exciting mathematics in a welcoming and inclusive environment at the University of Denver while I was a National Science Foundation postdoctoral fellow there. And I'm very proud of that program because I think it was overall a wonderful experience for the grad students and undergrads involved. I had several mentors that have been really, really important throughout my career. As an undergrad, I looked up to many of my professors, but in particular to Marta Urciolo and Cristina Turner, really, I should pronounce it. They were both professors at my university. They were generous, they were kind, they were excellent teachers, they were excellent researchers, they were real and honest about the joys and the struggles of being a mathematician in our department at the time. And they were both really strong women that I admired and I wanted to be like. So they were really important in the beginning of my undergrad studies. When I was in grad school, the teaching staff were extremely supportive and important for me during my program. In teaching, I found a lot of wonderful connections with students, and through many hard times, it was the teaching that kept me engaged in my PhD program. So I was very grateful to all the teaching staff, and in particular to Miki Havlikova, who was always very generous and supportive while I was at Yale. And more recently, I had a child, and this was a whole new challenge professionally. And Katrina Baron, who's a wonderful collaborator, and Gaywali Yamskulna, another wonderful collaborator. They're both amazing researchers, amazing mentors, and generous collaborators who also have children, and they've been extremely, extremely important for me since I can talk to them about research problems we're thinking about, but also about ways in which I can travel to a conference while breastfeeding a small child, ways in which I can, make sure that I can still participate in a research activities if I have caregiving responsibilities. They've been just really, really wonderful and helpful in all aspects of making research life compatible with my family and personal life. And also I have two friends who are wonderful mathematicians, Julia Plavnik, Ana Ros Camacho, who are a little more senior than me. And also had children recently, and they've been really helpful because it's not so easy to learn how to find childcare in a place that you've never been before. How to organize a day in which you'll be in a conference, but also coordinate with your partner or with a caregiver, how to make that work in a hotel room or in an Airbnb or whatever you can find, you know, to make your participation in a conference viable. I will say what many other people have said in Meet a Mathematician already. Find your crew, find people who love you, who support you, who will be rooting for you, and who will be available to have difficult conversations when discouraging messages get to you. I think many of us understand that there are some structures in mathematical spaces that can be discouraging, that math spaces weren't originally designed with all of us in mind. And even though we understand it, we discuss it, and we can choose to not accept that, it's very difficult not to be discouraged. It's very difficult not to be touched, disciplined by these messages. So I think my words of wisdom, especially if you are feeling discouraged and if you are having a tough time, is that I think that's very common for all of us. And I encourage you to talk to people, to share your struggles, and to find others with whom you can organize and think of ways to change unwelcoming situations in your department or your mathematical space.